Why hello there.
Honey, come home. It's getting late.
I'm coming, Mom.
Dinner is served. I want to eat all your food and then go straight to your bed.
Mom, I'm done.
All right, baby. Now to your bed. Wow, my little baby is all ready to bed.
Mom, will you tell me a story to get asleep?
Of course, sweetheart. Once upon a time, there was a mage who was looking for the meaning of life. One day, while she was in the forest, she heard a girl crying. She approached Shibeta and showed three wolves who have encircled a little girl. The maid dismounted from her tiger and casted a spell, which turned all three wolves into ships. After that, the maid approached the little girl, asking her,
"Are you all right?"
"Yes, I'm fine. Thank you very much for saving me."
"It is dangerous for you to stay here alone. Let's go and find you a safe place to stay."
"Okay."
"Let's move on."
Mage was trying hard to find a safe place to little girl, but none was an appropriate one. So, without losing their faith, they continued walking and searching for a home, and when felt tired, they stopped to regain their strength. In all the time, Mage tried to sympathize the little girl. And a strange connection between them started to create. With the company of the little girl, Mage became a little child for a while. So, they were playing together. Running together, even fishing together. One rainy day, something terrible happened. In Mage's path, a pack of dragonkin appeared from nowhere. The mage and the little girl turned around and walked away. But on the opposite direction, another pack of dragonkin was standing there as well. And in no time, the dragonkins from both sides started to run in Mage's direction, because a vicious attack had been ordered by a supreme being. The earth was trampling on dragonkin's footsteps and approaching the mage closer and closer. Mage casted a massive spell that managed and killed all dragonkins. No matter how hard he tried, little girl had gone. We'll be right back. Maids needed some answers for the attack, so she decided to visit her master. The journey was long and difficult. She was traveling 3 days, and at the end of the third day, she finally reached her destination. Mage greeted her master, and he greeted back to her.
Master, I need to know if Nefarian can be killed by a mortal.
The task you are asking is very difficult. In order to deadly wound Nefarian, a gem and a powerful ring are needed. Four dragons are the keepers of a spirit gem, each guarding a piece. They are vicious and will do everything they can to deceive you. So beware all of them. Regarding the ring, no one knows where it is or how it looks like.
The mage and her loyal tiger friend were traveling to quest the first piece of the gem. After a couple days of trip, she found the desired location she had instructed by her master. She approached the dragon and said,
I require the gem, dragon.
I can provide you passage and reveal to you the true form of the gem, but I have to warn you that in your path you will find obstacles.
Since the dragon was friendly, he shared with the maid the information of where the rest of the pieces are hidden. Mage thanked the kind dragon and moved ahead for the piece. But all the time, Mage was suspicious with the dragon's behavior, so she was extra cautious. The dragon kept his promise and revealed the true form of the gem, and our friend reached her hand and retrieved the piece. After the retrieval of the first piece, Mage was moving to the next location as instructed by the dragon. On top of the platform was standing a flying dragon, and the mage with steady pace walked towards him. When mage reached the dragon, she requested the piece from him.
I am Isandra, the keeper and guardian of the peace. My task is to protect it and eliminate anyone is trying to remove it from its position.
So the dragon refused to deliver the item to the mage, and in no time, fight began. The fight was intense and kept a couple of minutes with mage and dragon trying to eliminate each other. The dragon was trying to hurt mage with his claws and by spewing poison on him. The mage, on the other hand, was hitting him with his staff as hard as he could. The dragon, with persistent attacks, was that close to kill our hero, but at the right time, Mage had his back and managed to hit him in the head and kill him instantly. And the road for the second piece was wide open now. On the next day, our hero was traveling in Duskwood, searching the location for the third piece. And the location was found after a while. The piece was guarded by a sleeping dragon. Mage instructed his fellow tiger to move quietly and go towards the piece. Without waking the dragon, Mage moved away fast to the third piece in her possession. Mage tirelessly was searching the last piece. Something wasn't right. The whole place had the feeling of abandonment, but she was ready to draw her staff and fight. For her own surprise, no one was there to guard the piece. She carefully walked and took the last piece. After the acquisition of all four pieces, males walk through a lake to rest for a while. She was so tired that slept almost immediately. A strange dream unfolded in her sleep. A big fiery mountain. A road leading inside the mountain. A red sky. A big half-opened door. And for last, a very strange symbol. At the end, Mates decided to go and visit the mountain. After 2 days' trip, Mates arrived to the mountain which Zoe had dreamed. Entering to the mountains, screamed a war cry that sounded deep in the mountain and started to eliminate anything standing between her and the symbol she saw in the dream. So, she was facing any kind of strange creatures with incredible powers like fiery elementals, shadow and fire-based flame awakens. Lava elementals. When she finally found out the symbol, she raised her hand holding the merged gem. And then a miracle happened. The symbol activated the view of the gem by launching three pulsing lines. Mates started to follow the pulsing lines which were leading deep to the heart of the mountain. It appears that lines in Verabath activated some weird runes which were engraved on the walls. When all three runes activated, a massive beam of explosion hit the lava. After that, Mace was slowly moving towards the exit of the mountain with a staff in her hand. So, with the staff in her hand and without knowing where to search for the ring, Mace decided to go to Nefaria's lair. She opened a portal and instantly teleported into the cave. Inside the cave, Mage saw that the little girl was captured into a cage.
Eliminate the intruder.
A portal created and a dragonkin walked out of it. Mage looked left and right to find out that many more portals were created. Many dragonkins appeared from the portals and were ready to attack, but the mates had a plan. She raised the staff in the air and hit it to the ground, activating the crystal. While the dragonkins ran forward to kill the mates, staff's crystal pulsed and launched a deadly beam that instantly killed all dragonkins at once. After killing all dragonkins, mates approached Nefaria, who transformed into dragon to gain his powers. Deliver me the girl.
If you want her, come and claim her.
The drums of war started to sound, and battle was ready to start. Mates initially created started to cast powerful fireballs, which Neverian could stand. The Farian was spitting fire all over the place, but the barrier was holding. After that, he made to shelter to powerful figures, but the Farian was still holding. Both were trying their best to hurt each other. The little girl was hiding her eyes from time to time. Battle was going on endlessly, and spells were nullified whenever they hit one another. A vicious attack by Nefarian destroyed Paige's barrier, leaving her exposed. The mage with a spell rebuilt the destroyed ground. Nefarian was ready to kill mates with the next pyroblast, but the staff activated once again and protective wings appeared from nowhere and absorbed the good of it. That time, little girl threw an item to mates. It appeared to be a ring. One more fireball was cast by the mage and the ring embedded to the spell. At the same time, Nefarian was casting a pyroblast. Spells connected again, but Fireball destroyed pyroblast and hit Nefarian for deadly wounds. That was the end of the mighty Nefarian.
That was a nice story, Mom.
Yes, indeed, it was.
What happened to the little girl?
She was relocated to a safe place by the mage.
One more thing, Mom.
Yes, honey?
That ring has special powers.
Yes.
Was the ring that Master told to mage to look for?
Yes, honey, that's the ring.
And where is that ring now, Mom?
No more questions, baby. It's time to sleep.